This week's top Disney news stories include a giant movie reshuffle. There are also some quick stories about the Disney parks. So stay tuned and I'll break it all down. Well, hello there. My name's Jeremy, and welcome back to Freeform Disney, where I talk about all aspects of Disney, from the animated movies to the theme parks to Star Wars, Marvel, and Pixar, and the TV shows, and everything else in between. And that is why it's Freeform. And keep coming back every day for new daily content. If you're not subscribed yet, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Now it's that time of the week once more, so on to this week's biggest Disney news stories. Now this is going to be a really quick week because there's just not that much to talk about this time. But hey, we still did have at least one really big set of changes. And so with that, our top story of the week is a big old Disney movie shuffle. So Disney moved a whole bunch of movies, double digit number here. First off the bat, Mulan, which was originally scheduled August 21st after it had gotten bumped back from July, after it had gotten bumped back from earlier in the year, etc. Well, now it's no longer August 21st. It's off the calendar entirely. So who the heck knows when exactly it's going to go back on the schedule at this point? We don't know. There's one other movie that got completely removed off the schedule, and that's The French Dispatch. We don't know when they're coming back yet. We'll have to play that one by ear. Now, the other huge one is all those Star Wars and Avatar movies coming up. Now, there were 4 Avatar sequels coming up, and 3 Star Wars, as originally assumed to be a trilogy, still thought to maybe be a trilogy, but it's unsure at this point. Hard to say. Anyway, those were starting up, well, heck, just next year, so 2021. And then 2022 and 2023 and 2024 and 2025 and 2026 and 2027. Woo! Well, anyway, all of those have gotten delayed by 1 year. So it's the same order, 3 Star Wars movies all surrounded by Avatar movies. But they're all a year later, so you'll have to wait till 2022 for Avatar, and it won't finish up now till 2028. It'll be a while. And Spider-Man 3, in the meantime, has taken advantage of the fact that Avatar just went ahead and moved out of that Christmas time slot next year, so now it's going to be popping into that time slot, away from its November release, now over into December. A couple of the other delays, we had Guillermo del Toro's movie Antlers. It ended up getting delayed to February of next year. Ridley Scott's The Last Duel shifted from Christmas time this year all the way back to October of next year. Now, a couple other things, though. The New Mutants is apparently still scheduled for August 28th right now. And apparently, Personal History of David Copperfield was bumped back by a mere 2 weeks to also open on August 28th. Now, if you want to make your bets that those are actually going to open, at least here in the US on August 28th, I'll take those bets. Because I definitely don't think that's happening here in about a month's time. Highly unlikely. Now, could they open in the rest of the world on the August 28th and just not open in the US at that point? Well, that is possible, but I would not expect it here. I mean, heck, just recently AMC even announced their theaters will be closing the US until at least mid or late August. And we can probably expect that to keep going, especially with how things are going right now. Oof. Not good times here in the US with coronavirus, that is for sure. Now, things that might have a better shot of actually opening when they're currently scheduled, Black Widow is still set for November 6th, and Soul is still set for November 20th. By the time it hits November, maybe those will actually open up at their currently scheduled time. Now, neither of those were originally scheduled for that point, but hey, that's where they are now. There you have it, a whole bunch of movies shuffled and moved around, and I'm a big Star Wars fan, so I'm looking forward to those coming out. I'm also a big Avatar fan, really like the first movie. I'm looking forward to what James Cameron does with the sequels. And yes, even if it's well over a decade until the first of those sequels comes out from the original movie coming out years and years ago, still excited and still looking forward to that. So hey, there we go. And with that, it's time for everyone's favorite section, the lightning round. A few quick headlines of bigger stories. First off, this week, right now, it's still going on. We have Comic-Con at home. Still a few panels up there that you can watch. And a bunch of the ones that have already finished are up on YouTube. You can go watch them for free. I don't know how long they'll be up there for sure, so make sure to see them if you want to go ahead and check out those panels. And hey, I've got a video on that if you want to check that out too. And while we're talking about Comic-Con, there's actually a whole bunch of news on Star Wars books given out at the Star Wars publishing panel over at Comic-Con. So all kinds of new upcoming books that they gave information about. A couple Disney Parks things. First off, Oogie Boogie Bash at Disney's California Adventure has been canceled for Halloween 2020. Probably not the biggest surprise, but that's another one on the cancellation list. Disney has tightened their mask-wearing rules. They used to let you go ahead and eat while you were walking around. Now, no more. If you're wanting to eat or drink, you've got to go ahead and actually stop, be stationary. And that's true at Walt Disney World and Downtown Disney in California. And hey, I told you this one was going to be quick, so that's the news for this week. Did I miss any big Disney news stories? What do you think about this latest movie shuffle? And hey, when do you think we will actually see Mulan get released in theaters? And let me know down below in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching. If you like the video, you know what to do. Share it, like it, and hey, I'll be back again tomorrow with another new video. If you haven't done it yet, don't forget to click that good old subscribe button. Have a magical day, and may the force be with you. Always.